The New York Times has published a non-peer-reviewed article highlighting the court case of plaintiffs Karen Dhanowa and Nilima Amin versus Subway Restaurants Incorporated, filed on January 21, 2021 in the U.S. District Court for the Northern District of California. The New York Times article and the court case documents claim that Subway's tuna fish sandwich doesn't contain any tuna, or at least doesn't contain 100% tuna. The entire lawsuit is based on a series of PCR tests, and that's where all the problems begin. Any decent laboratory technician knows very well that PCR-based DNA amplification is prone to errors if not carried out using tried and trusted laboratory protocols. But the biggest joke of the day is that the New York Times initially believed that PCR tests are used for identifying organisms based on protein amplification, when in reality, it is DNA amplification. Meanwhile, Videonium has come across a peer-reviewed scientific article published in the International Journal of Food Properties, a decent journal with an H index of 51, clearly demonstrating through a series of experiments that not all DNA extraction methods are created equal. Meaning, some methods give you good quality DNA, whereas many others don't. In addition, the manuscript authors also cite previous studies showing that DNA fragment size is a limiting factor when it comes to PCR-based amplification. It is a known fact that during the tuna canning process, the tuna DNA degrades into fragments that are smaller than 123 base pairs in length. In other words, the heavily fragmented DNA may not be optimal for PCR reactions in some cases. The scientists further state that the DNA extraction procedures involve use of certain chemical compounds that can inhibit the PCR reaction altogether. Interestingly, the authors have used the same species of tuna that Subway uses in its tuna sandwiches. It's called the yellowfin tuna. Quite evidently, some crucial controls seem to be missing from the outsourced laboratory experiments. Considering all of the above, we tend to believe that the lawsuit filed against Subway is largely unscientific. Many plaintiffs and lawyers, in an attempt to mint money, have, in the recent past, filed meaningless lawsuits against Subway. However, Subway has been successful in defending its policies and procedures with tremendous success. So, what's the take-home message? Subway, we love you. Plaintiffs, lawyers, and New York Times, not so much. Hashtag, I support Subway.